Round 18, we are back live for you. Folks, 5 minutes, full wide across clothes, new participants, and no slower deeper members for round 18 chair boxing, where we're going to do four punch combinations. That's right, none of those one, two silly steps. We're going to do the one, two, three, and drive it home for the four punch combinations throughout our entire routine. So I hope you're all prepared to get functified, have some fun, to work on that range of motion, to work on that cardiovascular, the endurance, that stamina, and more importantly, to focus on this motivational Monday. So clap those hands, stomp those feet, do your little happy dance or your functified dance. It's all you need is yourself, some energy, some invigoration, and your H2O, and hopefully you hit that H2O about 60 seconds or 60 minutes ahead of time before this routine. So if you're drinking right now, that's the 60 seconds ahead, and if you did it 60 minutes ago, then you're all prepared and ready for round 18. I'm Jesse Swart, nationally recognized inclusive fitness trainer, Silver Sneaker Flex instructor. This is being brought to you today by Community Health, Silver Sneakers, and JesseSwart.com. You know what's next? Chicka, 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 chicka. Guess who's back? The style and profound, wheeling and dealing, shaking and baking, moving and grooving, camouflage wearing, pink shoe rocking, high flying, Silver Sneaker Flex instructor, bringing you the big 3-0. That's the 4-0. You're not getting 40 minutes, Miss Daly, today. You're getting the big 3-0. 30 minutes of functified fun, flexibility, chair boxing, round 18. You can stand, you can take a seat, you can do what you want. It's player's choice. It's for you, the participants. You can pause me right now. You can continue to play. You can get that extra 60 seconds of water and hydration, or you can get busy. Partaking. But before we get started, there are a few things that I need to remind all participants, Silver Sneaker members, and functified meetings worldwide across the world about. And that is, grab that chair, use it. That's what it's for. Try to stay off that backrest, try to stay elongated. The other thing, so that you're safe, active, and secure throughout this entire exercise routine, I review something called the Flex 5. And number one of that Flex 5, I've been viewing these live, virtually guided exercise routines. The virtual liability. I'm going to review that right now with you. You should always consult with your physician before engaging in any physical activity program. By participating in this online exercise routine, you assume all dangers, hazards, and risks of such participation. The exercises demonstrated by the instructor in this online class are demanding. If you're unable to safely perform these exercises, please modify them for your own safety or choose a different set of exercises. That's Flex number one. Flex number two. Remember, I can't see you, so I can't correct your form, your mechanics, your posture, so if you're leaning one way or you're slouched back, I need you to do that for yourself. Pay attention to my form, my mechanics, my posture. They're not going to look exactly the same. We're at different ages, we're at different levels. Anybody that's partaking today, I just want to make sure that you're safe, secure, and active out. And definitely highlight that safety part. So if you're feeling any pain, discomfort, lightheadedness, or fatigue, have that seat. If you're seated, relax, get some hydration, grab an app, it really helps you. Hopefully, that you're learning one of the three ways that we have today, verbally, visually, or kinesthetically. I'm going to introduce all three of them, so hopefully you can jump on board, get round 18, get a little motivated, and work on that learning curve and work on your own pace, because I guarantee you, through these 30-minute journey, you're going to be energized, you're going to be motivated. That's why we call it Motivational Monday. It's going to enhance your mobility, improve your stability, elongate that spine and that posture. We're going to work with different planes, and always those ABCs get worked as well. Agility, balance, coordination, strength, stamina, stability, and sexiness all wrapped up into round 18. Number three of that Flex 5, monitor that breathing. I need you to make sure that you inhale and exhale. Right? Have that towel too in case you sweat a little bit, because that's number four. Monitor But as we work through these four punch combinations, you are going to get a little fatigued. It is round 18. We continue to add on what we do. It's not round one anymore, it's round 18. So think about it. You're already up there, you're working. We're in that. And then number five, hydrate. I'm gonna take my towel, I'm gonna put it right behind my chair in case I need it. And we're gonna get prepared. We're gonna get rocking. Round 18, here it is. Sit on the edge of that chair. We wanna do a quick warm-up. And that warm-up is gonna consist of just taking that left arm and going straight on up. Remember, you're sitting on the edge of that chair, tailbone's tucked in, belly button tucked as well, chest out, shoulders up, back, and down, and you're just trying to raise that left arm as high as you get. Now, I know some of you at home, you might have some limitations of motion, you might have some end range extension issues, that's meaning getting all the way to the top. So, you lift to where it is comfortable. Other side, we're going to that right side. You might have some shoulder impingement, you might have some rotator cuff injury, you might just have some overuse or arthritis. Those spurs that are in those shoulders, previous injury, you know, it might have felt back when you were in your 20s, you might have played tackle football, or I don't know, you could have been doing anything, and then both together. And now it's just creeping up as you get a little older, so we want to try to work those joints, we want to try to work the ball and socket, that is this shoulder, the ball and socket joint, it's very dynamic, and it allows you to extend, flex, and do really dynamic activity, which I'm going to show you in a moment. And we're going to take that left arm, we're going to go out to the side. So adaptations for this exercise is straight on out, a little more difficult, or bend it, a little less difficult. Your range of motion changes. So this is straight on out, and this is range of motion adaptation. So you choose which one works best for you. Right side, I'm going straight on out, but I will adapt, and I will do two a little closer to my body, and then I'll go back, there you go, and two close, and then I'll go nice and wide again, and then I'm going to put both hands together. Difficult, adaptation, a little more difficult, and then I try everybody to keep these synchronized. There you go. Try to get in the same. And then up again. Feel those shoulders. They're going to start burning with sizzle. How's everybody feeling right now? And shrug. I'm feeling great, but I can tell that I'm working my shoulders. A little overuse. That's why we try to really pay attention to how much shoulder use we do throughout our exercise routines. Because you use those shoulders, roll that left one back more than you imagine throughout your entire day. You get a lot of stress, you get a lot of tension up through those shoulders, which gets into the neck, and then that neck gets into the lower back, into the upper back, and then that's when we get that pain and discomfort. Now I'm going to the other side, so I'm on my right side, rolling it back. You want to take the elbow a little higher and roll back. This is where that ball and socket joint allows you to move through. And I'm going to go all the way to the other side, now left side, and I'm just changing the motion. And now alternate them. Now if you can't get the elbow up, again you have some discomfort, then just roll. Roll back, like this. See the roll? Or a little advance, elbow up. Because we're going to be moving into that four punch combination where we're going to be doing an 8, 6, and 4 throughout. I can't show you 8, 6, and 4 throughout. Wrestle down and come around. Ball and socket allows you to do exercises like this as well. 5, and you're feeling a little discomfort, come a little lower. So again, your game, your choice, you're the participant. If you can go high, wiggle, go high. If you need to go a little low, go a little low. Or if one has to go low and one has to go high, then you just go one high, one low. See what I'm doing? And then I'm going to cross in front. Get yourself prepared. If you need to hydrate, now's the perfect time to get an H2 out, H2O out, and start your hydration. I'm going to find mine. I'm going to find my towel. We are going to be going next. did an 8-6-4 repetition routine of the jab, jab. First one's gonna be hook, hook. Bobby Lee is gonna be in between. The music's gonna be a little slower at the beginning. So a quick reminder, quick rehearsal. First time taking the chair box on the English, okay, so that chair. Elongate with that spine. Our bob and weave looks like this. I go right, left. Keep it nice and tall. You're shifting your weight. Center of gravity's right here. You're shifting the weight. Find that motion back and forth. It's like you're bobbing and weaving from punch to punch. So our first motion is going to be left. So it's going to be jab, jab, and then hook, hook. Everybody has that? So jab, jab is a four-punch combination. So if I count it, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can elongate that hook if you want. Push, push. So short, short, elongate, elongate. So the body twists a little more. Push, push. Motivational Monday. Last 4, 3, 2, 1, and bob and weave. Awesome job. How you feeling at home? Should be loosened up. Shoulders should be loose. You're working that torso now. The torso's getting loose. The next one we're going to go to is a hook. All right? So we're going to extend these a little later in the next round. But now we're going to go back to that jab jab. There's going to be a hook hook. Watch. Here we go. Jab. Jab, hook, hook, jab, jab, hook, hook. So left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Jab, jab, the hook, aim from the jaw. Jab, aim from the shoulder level. So jaw, jaw, shoulder, shoulder, jaw, jaw, or sternum, sternum. Ear, ear. Got it? So you know where you're actually focusing your punches. And we're still doing that bob and weave, and it's still a four count. 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember, no loosey goosey on those punches. This isn't Mike Doocy's punching. This is chair boxing, round 18, Jesse Squire, nationally recognized inclusive fitness trainer, Silver Speaker Flex instructor, and we're bringing you the four. Punch. 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, last 4, and bob, right, left. Awesome job. How's everybody feel? Loosening up, feeling energized, feeling motivated. It is Motivational Monday. We're going to go through a six, not a six count punch. We're going to go through 6 reps of that. Here we go. First one, jab, jab, upper, upper. That's 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 5. 1, 2, 3, 6. Bob and wave. Everybody follows that punch combination. Over here. Picked up on it as we went through it. Another 6. This time, we're going to go through those hooks. Here we go. Jab, jab, hook, hook. That's 1. Jab, jab, hook, hook. 1, 2, 3, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 5. 1, 2, 3, 6. And then jab. How's it feeling out there? I'm from Fly Maniacs. Worldwide across the globe. Time to hydrate. Awesome work. We didn't get to that 4 count, but we did get through a bunch of 8s. We did you get through a bunch of sixes, 10, you work on those four punch combinations. I want you to hydrate down, get that H2O, you have that apple. Remember, that apple really helps you low glycemic index, helps you get that those calories in your body, helps you get those nutrients and carbohydrates to push you through this routine right now. Get the hydration. The next exercise we're going to after hydration is another four punch combination. Right? Get a little relaxed, get a little rested, pay attention to that rate of perceived exertion, assess right now. I know I'm starting to sweat, I'm actually going to lay my water bottle right next to me in case I need it. Starting to sweat a little bit. I'll put this here because I might need it throughout. We're going to pick it up now. So now it's going to be another four punch combination, right? But it's going to be a little different. So it's going to be left, right, left, and then a hook. But I'm going to punch straight on out. So it's going to be boom, 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 hook. Boom, 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 hook. Everybody has it? So it's going to be left, right, left, hook. Left, right, left, hook. Left, right, left, hook. And just remember, as you're doing this, tailbone is tucked in. Belly button, nice and tucked. Chest out, shoulders up, back, and down. Left, right, left, hook. Left, right, left, hook. Left, right, left, hook. Left, right, left, hook. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. No loosey-goosey with those fingers. I said it would pick up. Two, three, one, two, three, one. One, two, three, two. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, five. One, two, three, six. One, two, three, seven. Last one, bob and weave. Right, left. So we're going to pick it up. We're going to do the opposite way now. So now we're going to lead with that right hand. So we're going to slow it up. Here we go. Three, two, one. Right hand. Jab, 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 hook. Jab, 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 hook. Right, left, right, hook. Right, left, right, hook. Here comes the pace. One, two, three, one. One, two, three, two. One, two, three, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, five. One, two, three, six. One, two, three, seven. One, two, three, eight. Bob and weave. How's it feel? Need a sweat? Got that sweat going? If you need to hydrate, hydrate now. It's the time. We're going to bob and weave a little bit. We're going to add the next one. It's going to be the same format. It's just going to be an uppercut. I'll slow it down. We're going to lead with that left hand on three, two, one. So it's going to be jab, 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 up, left, right, left, up, left, right, left, up, left, right, left, up, left, right, left, upper, last, four, pace, go. One, two, three, one. One, two, three, two. One, two, three, three. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, five. One, two, three, six. One, two, three, seven. One, two, three, bob and weave. Right, left, right, left. Woo! Motivation Monday, Jesse Sawyer here, National Recognized Exclusive Fitness Trainer. This is Chair Boxing. Remember, you want to elongate that spine, you want to pay attention to that form, those mechanics, that posture that you have, elongate through the crown of your head, pay attention to center of gravity, and then your bottom weaving. You're shifting your weight and your feet nice and tall. We're going to go the opposite direction on three, two, one. So now it's going to be right, left, right, up. Got it? Right, left, right, up. Right, left, right, left upper. One, two, three. Last one. And we will pick the pace up. Right, left, one. One, two, three, two. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, five. One, two, three, six. Cross that midline. Last one. Bottom weave. How y'all feel? Feel good? Awesome job. High five yourselves. Yeah. Low five yourselves. You need to get that hydration right now. High five the person next to you. You get the hydration. We're going to go back to some of those moves. You did an awesome job doing it right now. You're feeling it. You're crossing that midline. Work on that center of gravity, you're bobbing, weaving, you're shifting that weight in the seat or standing. You can do these standing as well. I just choose to be doing it in a seated position because they can be exhausting and they do get that ready to proceed to exertion though. So please assess if you're ready to proceed to exertion right now. And hydrate. Awesome job. Seriously, participants. 4 to 5 minutes, pro wide across the globe, Jesse Sawyer here. Seriously, your flex instructor, bringing chair boxing, round 8.
Awesome job.
sure you hydrate. Pay attention to that rate of perceived exertion. Another time for you to assess where you're at. A little intense, a little hard. At that one point during that chair boxing, but we're bringing it back down. We should be at this is fun, and you can do this forever. So I expect you to be able to do this forever. And join me next week on Monday, 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. Motivation. And remember at the end, we do have a motivational quote, so do not leave me right away. I can send you on your mission and your journey, virtually guided and individually guided. So again, we're going to sit on the edge of that chair. If you're not already there, then join me. If you can join me, then stay back in that chair. I want you to relax. I want you to recover. I want you to renew as well. So sitting on the edge of the chair, remember your feet are anchored, shoulder width, hips width, distance apart, so your toes should line with your knees, knees should line with the hips, and hips should line with the shoulders. Right? Good position. Nicely elongated up, chest down, tailbone in, belly tucked, one nice and tight stomach, right? Summer's almost over, and then I'm going to lift my hands up. My hands are going to be right at shoulder level, okay? Just right here. Good. And I'm just going to hold it. Nice good elongation. So you're going to stay in this position. I'm going to try to drive those elbows down, and I'm just going to come up. And I'm driving those elbows right in to the side of my stomach. Right to my rib cage. As I do that, though, I am squeezing my spinal column, the spinous erectus. So I'm trying to stay nice and erect. I'm paying attention to my postural awareness and elongation of my spine. So I'm up and then driving down, squeeze. Up, squeeze. You should feel the back. We want you to feel those back muscles. We want you to feel the muscles right through here. The latissimus dorsi, that's what we're really working right now. It's the long muscle right through here on both sides. And then I want you to just climb in. And now with this motion, I'm working the serratus muscle. The serratus muscle is right through here. A little higher. Not higher with your arms, but a little higher than the latissimus dorsi. The latissimus dorsi runs through here, serratus muscle runs through here. It allows you to retract and protract. Nice and easy. And if you gotta lower your arms a little lower, go ahead, lower them a little lower. We don't wanna put any extra strain on those shoulders. We want you to be able to just flow back, and as I flow back, I'm squeezing. So look, I'll go to the side, squeeze. I'm keeping them low. As you see, my shoulders aren't high. They're low, and I'm trying to bring them together. So I'm trying to take those elbows and squeeze. I'm off that exercise chair, but if you have to be on that exercise chair, then you're just trying to squeeze behind that chair. You're giving your back a little bit of rest, and you're giving your back a little bit of support. You may do it that way. It's just moving through. I choose to sit on the edge of the chair because it helps me throughout my day and your day stay nice and strong. Work on that core strength, work on stability, and elongate the spine and remove some of the excessive thoracic composers when we're leaning forward. And our back muscles get weak and our chest muscles start compromising our ability with those shoulders tightening where we can't breathe as much. So I want you to open those chest muscles up now. It is. Chair boxing, round 18. We're at the finale. You made it. And then just up and down. I'm pulling them back. You feel any discomfort, pain, the impingement on those shoulders as we do that? Then lower it down a little bit more. A little lower. Or keep them together and just pull back. Like this. Chest is out though. And nice and high. Should be elongated, and then I want you to drop those arms all the way down. I want you to come straight up with me. I want you to stop that bus right there. Open those hands nice and wide. Bring those elbows back down to that rib cage. Fingers are still nice and wide. Nice, good deep breaths. Nice big inhalation here. And exhalation. Another big inhalation. And exhalation. Inhalation. Exhalation. Hands should be nice and wide still. You're taking that thumb and that pinky finger and you're making it nice and wide. Your inhalation, exhalation, and then you're going to drop them down. Wiggle those fingers at the bottom. You complete it. Round 18. You might have joined me for the first time today being like not knowing what to expect and thinking this is chair boxing, man. This might be out of my comfort zone. This not,
might be something I might not be able to do. But listen, you completed it. You made it through it. You had options to hit the pause button, hit the play button, assess your perceived rate of exertion. No matter where you're at on that scale, it's your game, it's your choice. You can hit that pause, you can rewind it, you can play it, you can find me on YouTube, you can come back on Monday, or you can join me tomorrow on Tuesday, or every Tuesday, and you can do a little bit of Tai Chi, where we slow it down a little bit, and we work on movements that are meant for you, either seated or standing, to renew you, and allow you to move a little more harmonious through your day, working on those joints, those ball and socket joints, those really dynamic joints, hip and shoulder. Remember, as we did this on the past Friday, we're working on a better you. And with a better you, we got a motivational Monday. Now, before I get to the very end, I got to get my quote book. It's right up here. I actually wanted to do something else with you today, but hey, we missed it. I wanted to do a 30 and 30 where we moved it really fast and through our motions. We didn't get there, which is okay. We got through some other motions. We'll get to that next time high energy shows up. So here it is. Now and then, it's good to pause in our pursuit of happiness and just be happy. So on this motivational Monday, I want you to pause for one moment in your own pursuit or whatever you're doing and just be happy in the moment. Be happy in the fact that you tuned in today when you could have been doing something else. That you spent those 30 minutes out of that 150 that you're trying to get each and every week so that you can live longer, have a better quality of life, and maintain that independence throughout life, no matter where you might be. You might be 21 right now. You might be 30. You might be in your 60s. The fact is that you're here and you're pursuing that happiness. Take that pause and be happy. High five me, high five that neighbor because you made it through. And hopefully you join me on Tuesday. And hopefully you join me next week for round 19. You know how we always do. Again, my name is Jesse Swore. My time is up. I'm humbled by your time. From the window to the wall. Ski, 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 ski. You are. Peace. Hydrate. Bring your towel. Bring your H2O. Eat those apples.